Hello everyone, my name is Kumar Aditya. I'm an electrical engineer at Continental Automotive Canada. Today I'm gonna show you the simulation motor for the permanent magnet synchronous motor. So I've created this simulation for the LTspice simulation tool. Here you see the on the left hand of the screen, this is the simulation circuit, and on the right side of the screen, this is the result obtained using the simulation circuit. So let me first describe the simulation circuit. So this is the motor model, and these are the this sub circuit represents the parameter of the motor model. So this motor parameters has been taken from an online data sheet of a motor. So inductance is 82.9 microhenry, resistance is 122 milliohm, back EMF constant is 1.2 milli, and number of pole pairs are 2. RB represents the friction coefficient of the motor and load, and LJ represents the inertia of motor and load. To test the model, I am using analog test fixture, which is basically a 3 sinusoidal voltage source, 120 degree apart, and the modulating frequency or the line frequency is 2000 Hz. So for a line frequency of 2000 Hz, synchronous motor of 4 pole should give a synchronous speed of 60 kRPM. And this here represents the DQ axis conversion. So these are the 3 phase current. I'm converting into the alpha beta reference frame, and then from alpha beta to DQ reference frame. The model have been implemented using SPICE language. So this is the lib file of the motor created by me. Now coming back to the simulation result, you see here this is the 3 phase current going into the motor terminal IU, IV, IW, which has been plotted through here. And this is the air gap torque, pink trace here between the air gap torque or electromagnetic torque, and this blue trace represent the load torque. This is the D and Q axis current. And now I have used the voltage source, behavior source for implementing the D and Q axis conversion. So instead of showing the current IDIQ, LTspice is plotting as a VD and VQ, but these are current. This is the rotor electrical position, V theta. And on the top, I'm showing the rotor speed, mechanical speed of the motor. So at 50 millisecond, I have provided a step change in the load torque. So initially, I start the motor with 1 Newton millimeter of the load torque, and then I provide a step change in the load torque from 1 Newton millimeter to 4 Newton millimeter. Let me zoom at the transition period. So if you see, when I provide a step change in the load torque, my electromagnetic air gap torque also increases to meet the load torque demand. So pink trace closely follows the load torque trace. So, and there is a slight difference between the air gap torque and the load torque, which is due to the loss in the friction coefficient. So, you know, higher the friction coefficient, more mechanical loss will occur. So this effectively verifies that the friction of the motor is being recognized by the simulation. Now, in a synchronous motor, if I change the load torque, my synchronous speed should not change. That is the property of synchronous motor, that it will rotate at synchronous speed only, or it will not rotate at all. So you can see during transition period, before and after transition period, speed remains same. It does not change. It remains fixed at 60 kRPM. Now KV here means kilo RPM because SPICE only recognize fault or current or temperature or watt. It does not know any RPM. So it so KV means here RPM, and this is the motor current. So they are sinusoidal, 120 degree apart. Another thing which I used to verify whether my model is predicting the correct real motor behavior or not, I plotted the D and Q axis current. So it's a permanent magnet motor. So flux, if I'm not doing any flux weakening, my flux is constant. So D axis current you see here is constant. It does not changes with the changing load. But that load demand, increased load demand, should be met by motor in some way. So here you see the Q axis current, it increases with the increasing load torque to produce more electromagnetic torque to support the synchronous speed. So here it verifies that the model is working correctly. Now one thing to note here is that I have started this motor in open loop without any BYF control or field oriented control, and it managed to rotate asynchronous speed. So but in permanent magnet synchronous motor or synchronous motor in general, they are not self starting. So to verify the model, I have kept the inertia very low. You know, because of inertia, synchronous motor are not self starting. It produces electromagnetic torque which is pulsating, and average value is zero, so your motor fails to start. So let me show you. If I put the realistic value of inertia from data sheet, which was 3.2 nano newton meter per radian per second square, 3.2 micro newton meter per radian per second square. If I use the realistic value and run the simulation, you will see that the motor will fail to start. So now the air gap torque is pulsating. So you see the sinusoidal, the air gap torque is sinusoidal, then average value is zero. So motor will fail to start. And this you can observe in the theta rotor position plot here. You see the rotor position remains at zero radian. It does not change. However, after some times, it do try to go in the reverse direction, and which you observe here in the speed plot, that speed slightly is trying to increase in the negative direction. This may be due to the reason that in this region, there may be some average value of load, average value of electromagnetic torque, which is not very high to bring it to the synchronous speed, but it is enough to provide a kick to the motor in the reverse direction. So this essentially sums up my presentation. So simulation model works just fine. It manages to capture the real behavior of a permanent magnet motor. In this model, I have not included the saturation effect of inductor and the permanent magnet. That is my next target or goal. Also, I'm gonna put this motor model in a field-oriented control implemented in the LTspice environment. So I will present that in the next video. For now, goodbye. Take care. Have a nice day. Thank you.